Judas reveals his hidden contempt for Jesus. But Jesus relates to Judas as a friend up to the very end. We are in the Holy Week. Today's gospel presents a conducive scene in Bethany that would initiate us into the joy of being in the company of Jesus amidst the tragedy of passion and death of Jesus on the cross. Jesus came to the house of Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. These people loved Jesus. Jesus is human and he finds another home. He is welcomed as his mother does. It is an atmosphere of intimacy and generosity. On the other hand, there is a prelude to what is going to happen to him on Calvary. Judas Iscariot becomes jealous of Mary and spews out subtle poisonous venom of insult. Again, there were Pharisees trying to plot against Jesus. Strangely, Judas goes out of the house right after Mary's display of devotion to Jesus, Matthew 26:14 and Mark 14:10, and finds the Pharisees and actually forms a plan to betray Jesus. Seeing Mary's adoration of Jesus throws him over the edge in rage or anger or jealousy. Judas reveals his hidden contempt for Jesus. But Jesus relates to Judas as a friend up to the very end, Matthew 26:49-50. As we reflect today, we need to ask ourselves whether there is love within us like Mary who anointed Jesus, or whether we are driven by anger, jealousy and insult to people around us. When we are driven by these poisonous negativities in life, we can cause havoc in the life of others. Judas and Pharisees could manage to lead Jesus to Calvary. We may many times lead people to negativity and cause unnecessary sufferings in the lives of others if we are driven by these poisonous aspects in our life. Holy Week is a time we examine and see where we are standing. Let us pray that if there is love in us for Jesus, we may pray it to grow so that we may bear fruits of the Spirit as Mary did bear: love, joy, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and meekness. If at all we find that we are vexed with anger, jealousy, lust and indifference that led Judas and Pharisees to plot against Jesus, we shall pray that Jesus may grant us forgiveness and liberate us from these poisonous states of hatred.